In this video, I am going to discuss about social learning theory and its classroom implications. Observation of others' behaviors may play a leading role in learning and acquiring various things concerning one's environment. The cognitive psychologists who appreciate the role of observation in learning are termed as social psychologists, and the theory of learning they propagate is known as social learning theory. Observational and vicarious learning, learning through indirect experience rather than the learning based on the direct experience, is thus the base of the social learning theory. The advocates of this theory emphasize the most of what we learn is occurred through simply watching and listening to the other people. The children from very beginning keenly observe the behavior of others, most commonly of people nearest to them, like parents, members of the family, teachers and older members of the society, etc. In turn, they try to imitate and do what they observe. The power of observational learning can be confirmed through experiment as well as through the observation in our daily life. Albert Bandura's social learning theory. Albert Bandura was a prominent American social learning theorist, and social learning theory is often designated as Bandura's social learning theory. Introducing his theory, Bandura writes, "We do not blindly respond to the environmental stimuli, rather we pick and choose from many experiment options, opinions, based on our decisions, on our own insights and past experience. This we do through vicarious or observational learning, by incorporating and imitating the behavior of those around us." Bandura reflects that people learn through observing others' behaviors, attitudes and outcomes of this behavior via observation, imitation and modeling. The theory has often been called a bridge between the behaviorist and cognitive learning theories because it encompasses attention, memory and motivation. He also added two important ideas: mediating process occur between stimulus and response, and behavior is learned from the environment through the process of observational learning. Albert Bandura's social learning theory, he explained how does the learning takes place. According to the social learning theory, one learns through observation by incorporating and imitating the behavior of others taken as models belonging to one's social environment. According to Bandura, the following process or steps are usually involved in these kinds of learning. Attending to perceive the behavior. This means, in this step, learner is made to observe the behavior of the person acting as a model. Here, the total behavior of the particular aspect of it may attract attention and become the subject of close attention. Remembering the behavior. In this step, what the learner observes is filed away in his memory in the form of mental images. Then, converting the memory into action. In this step, behavior observed and remembered by the learner is analyzed in terms of its acceptability to the learners with reference to the demands of his self and his environment. It is turned into action only afterwards, and thus observed relevant and accepted aspects of the model behavior are imitated by the learner. Reinforcement of the imitated behavior. In this final step, the behavior of the model imitated by the learner is reinforced for proper adaption and further continuance. Albert Bandura's social learning theory provides some necessary conditions for effective modeling also. Attention. Various factors increase or decrease the amount of attention paid, include distinctiveness, affective valence, prevalence, complexity, functional value. One's characteristics affect attention. Retention. Remembering what you paid attention to, include symbolic coding, mental images, cognitive organization, symbolic rehearsal, motor rehearsal, etc. Reproduction. Reproducing the image, including the physical capabilities and self-observation of reproduction. Motivation. Having a good reason to imitate includes motives such as past, promised and vicarious. In this way, social learning, that learning through observation and modeling, proves to be an effective means of learning many things concerning one's behavior. How one displays love and anger, shows sympathy and prejudice, speaks and writes, dresses and eats, all depend upon what has been observed, remembered, imitated and reinforced in the context of vicarious or model learning as proposed by social learning theory. Education implication of social learning theory. Students learn a great deal simply by observing others. Describe the consequences of behavior increases appropriate behaviors, decreasing inappropriate ones. This includes discussing the rewards of various behaviors. Modeling provides an alternative to teaching new behaviors. Instead of using shaping and operant conditioning, modeling is faster, more efficient means of teaching. To promote effective modeling, teachers must ensure the four essential conditions exist: attention, retention, motor reproduction, and motivation. Teachers must model appropriate behaviors and take care they do not model inappropriate behaviors. Teachers should expose students to a variety of models. This is important to break down stereotypes. Students must believe that they are capable of accomplishing a task. It is important to develop a sense of self-efficacy for students. Teacher can promote such self-efficacy by having students receive confidence building messages, watch others be successful, and experience success on their own. Teacher should help the students set realistic expectations, ensuring that the expectations are realistically challenging. Sometimes a task is beyond a student's ability. Self-regulation techniques provide an effective method for improving students' behaviors. Students may consult the following reference for further studies. Thank you.